He niggles the opposition.
Lingy.
And my man is Ty Vickery. Really important that he improves now. He copped a bit of flack from last week. Number 8 draft pick. Here we go. It should be fun.
Start of the game here at the MCG. Ruckman there. And, of course, you see the shot of Pendlebury starting on the bench as well. Deledio. Quick handball out wide. Opportunity, Cotchin. A little heavy on the handball then. Side bottom able to break the tackle. Great handball, wasn't it? Real opportunity here for Sinclair. Inside 50, corralled by Hooley. Opportunity once again for the Pies. Knocked off the ball brilliantly. And the Tigers in numbers. Rants. A little iffy at times last week. Cotchin the star. Kick wasn't great, but it's going to work.
Yeah.
And Newman, the captain, taking possession there. This is an area with the umpire called play on. They've had enormous trouble with getting themselves out of half-back. That is their best kick across there. They want to get it in Chris Newman's hands.
Maric, almost the wrong option, back inside, but they now go. The man they want kicking the ball, Deledio, one-on-one with Riewoldt. Was he bumped off the ball? Did he flop? The umpire said, you flop, Jack. Otherwise, it would have been Shepparton before the ball arrived. There's Marty Clark.
Yeah, had an open 50 there, Brett Deledio, but the forwards were running backwards. Someone needed to present at him.
Clark again, Swan involved in the contest there. A little push out, you heard the umpire say. Against that man, Chris Newman, for solo. Wearing the number 1, Guernsey, good looking ball. And Luke Ball has marked right on his limits. He loves shots from here. He's very, very accurate.
He doesn't normally miss inside 45 metres. Here we go here. Jack did turn around to present at the ball carrier and just bumped off the ball there. I'm not thinking he was too happy, Jack.
Kicked 18 goals from his 21 set shots last year, Luke Ball. When he came across from St Kilda, that was supposed to be an issue. He's got it right, BT.
He has indeed. Plays within his capabilities, Darce. Has a shot from this range. Any further out, he'd try and offload it. In comes Ball. Kick looks pretty good. A little right, hit the timberwork.
Always happens, Darce, when you give them a pump up.
Now, I'm interested in this part of the ground here, Richo, because the Collingwood forward press defensively has been as good as any side of the competition. They'll be working overtime, and again, that's a win. Doors coming through. We'll just keep it inside 50.
The Richmond kick-ins last week were deplorable. They just couldn't get it back into play cleanly and quickly.
Yeah, they lost confidence. They didn't really have a plan after it all fell apart.
I'm imagining they would have worked on that very heavily this week. Here's side bottom. Around the body, gets it in towards the direction there of Cloak. Cloak competing for the ball at ground level. Opportunity now for Grimes. Under Cloak pressure. Got it back and threw for a behind in the end.
Interesting you talk about the kick-ins. Hawthorn actually kicked 5 goals from kick-ins last week against Collingwood. So their press wasn't working that well last week. Let's see how Richmond go here.
Back into play with a slow play this time. Newman has to try and pick his way through this rolling defence. Finds Deledio. He goes boundary. Here's Martin. Big job tonight required from him if Richmond to win. Transfer of play looking here. Rance is not the guy you want kicking it, but he works the angle nicely to Newman. Newman wants the run and he gets it from Martin. Impressive play from the Tigers. Patient set up from the back half. Kick out wide. Up they go. Morris was in there. Opportunity at ground level. Basher Hooley gets it out wide to Morris. You can't miss him. 70 metres. Is it downfield? Yes, it is. High tackle down the ground. Jack Riewoldt, I think, will get proceeds.
It'll be Riewoldt who will be the beneficiary here. That setup was on the back of one good kick from Alex Rance. He was able to just dissect one through the middle. Then they were able to break open with some space. It's so important that you use the ball well at half-back, Richard.
It's risk-reward. You go in there and turn it over, it's a goal. You go in there and you maintain possession, you normally get it inside 50.
The sharpshooter from Tigerland in the forward pocket at their beloved punt road end, Jack Riewoldt. Lines them up, and it's a poster apiece.
And we have seen that in the opening rounds, Darce. Teams are really prepared to have a crack at getting it back into the middle because the game then unfolds from there.
Don't forget, you can be interactive with us all night. We'd love to read your tweets. O'Brien, out wide to Dawes, and Conker sees it over the line.
Spoke to Nathan Buckley in the pre-game. We spoke, Richo, about the fact that last week they went inboard more than they've done ever under Mick Mouldhouse. Now, we're not sure whether that's going to be a permanent trend or something that just happened in round one. But already you're seeing just that preparedness, Collingwood, to go through the corridor a little more than they have done.
Cotchin got it forward. Over the top, Vickery, run down by side bottom. Tuvey to Keefe. Lockie Keefe, ordinary kick, got Cochum.
Good signs for Richmond, 28 possessions to 12. They've got a bit of control of the football, and there you go. Can't turn those over, though.
Has always been their problem, hasn't it? Talk about Collingwood tonight. They've definitely changed their style. Richo's all over that with some stats later on. Hooley did well. Got it to the little man back inside King. Keith was able to get a hand on it. Sharp handball. Penry got the overlap runner here from Shaw. Got a chase from behind. Won't get him. Shaw a driving kick to an open Collingwood forward line with only Richmond players. And in the end, it's Batchelor.
Well, that kick that was turned over inboard there from Collingwood before, that's the kick they never did last year, BT.
Greg to Hooley. Hooley a running bounce and once again a stumper. Here's Jake King. Does he give it to Riewoldt? Got a bit of time to get it around the corner. Riewoldt with a snap goal. Misses. Second behind for him.
They will be prepared to take risks on the fast break situation, Richmond, as we saw then. And it really busted open then, the Collingwood defence. Again, going back through the corridor, they're able to get some clean space and some clean air. And clear possession.
Just the kicks inside 50 at the moment from both teams have been sloppy. Basher Hooley had a lot of time to make that decision, and he normally nails those kicks.
Short of Harry O'Brien. Harry O'Brien, good length on the kick to penalty. Didn't quite get to him. Cochin got a very timely hand there. Dawes was in amongst it. Weave his way through on that occasion was ball. In the end, had to retreat out of it. Grimes in front. The kick again. Kicking in defence from the Tigers. Just not their go. Here's Beams back in the side for Collingwood. One of two changes. He and Tarrant back in. Rounds and Yagmore out of the side. Goldsack. Cloak on his favoured left side. To get over the head to Sinclair. It goes to Payne. He runs into the goal. Collingwood get the first.
So, mistake, kicking error sets up the first goal of the game. And it was Dylan Grimes, who's a really good, honest defender. But again, not a player who is naturally gifted by foot. And we've seen that one just go over the head, and result was a Collingwood goal.
So, there is the goal. Payne just sending it along the ground. I don't know why the modern player does that these days, Richo. Perhaps you've got an explanation.
What, dribbles it along the ground?
Yeah, instead of just kicking it.
Well, that's the one that set up the goal, Richo. Grimes' defensive kick, just a real issue for the Tigers. I think they've got to get Delidio back across halfback, Richo. I know you want three of him, but it's going to be an issue for them all year. He's probably their most highly skilled player by foot. He's got to start at halfback.
Kick down towards Riewoldt. Meeting the sandwich. Keith did well to recover. Here's Brandon Ellis. Opportunity for him. Another call to Cannons. A very, very good kick. Like to see him coming off half-back. And Delidio is able to cut a hole through them. Kick around the corner once again. It's Riewoldt. This time Reed and Tarrant double-teaming him.
Well, I think at some stages tonight, Darcy definitely will play some footy across half-back. He is a good user of the football. So I think he will spend some time across there tonight.
Jolly doing the ruck work. Look at the back. Reed in amongst it. Harry O'Brien gave it straight to the Tigers, and it was Edwards who missed the pretty easy goal in the end by hitting the post.
I reckon he called for that one, and Harry sandballed it over to Shane Edwards.
A little bit of panic in the Pies defender there, unusual for Harry O'Brien. Here's Goldsack.
Good well to hold him up here, Richmond.
Got a mismatch for Tyrone Vickery's caught out on Travis Cloak, if they can get it into him.
Ball to Pendlebury.
Always nervous for a ruckman when you're chasing him around one of the half forwards. He's flapping his arms around Ty saying, come and help me, please.
Well, luckily for Tyrone, they've been able to hold it up. But Travis would have been thinking that was a pretty good opportunity.
Jolly, here comes the lead. Straight up the middle. Good-looking ball. Thomas couldn't quite get there. Now the Richmond defenders are in amongst it. Goldsack says, you go and get it, Fasolo. Fasolo does. Kick around the corner. Just offline. And in the end, another behind. Very smart player, Alex Fasolo. Only played 15 games of the top stuff so far. Basher Hooley got the duties from
kick in. He's got the ability to mark the ball, though, for Solo. For a small player, he can take a very good mark, which is a dangerous combination, as we saw Eddie Betts on Thursday night. If you can mark the ball as a small player, it makes you that much harder to play on.
Just seem to have worked their kick-ins. Obviously done a lot of work on that during the week, I would think, Richmond. They're just being very patient. I mean, a lot of teams are going that quick, you don't have time to set up. But I think Richmond, with their skills, need to be a little more careful.
Seen some Kilda play this way, within the limitations, their defenders. Just conservatively, if you're not a good kick, don't try and hit the miracle one. That from Chris Newman is not great, because that is one of his strengths.
He apologises to his teammate. There's Cloak, right near the bench. Sends it inside 50. Dawes has got a bit of a run and jump at this. Both hands on it, couldn't quite bring it down. Think it might have been Beams in and under, tackled there by Martin.
Fine. Thank you.
It was.
Thank you. It was like a really important night for Richmond tonight, Richo, on another big stage against a massive club. I don't think they necessarily have to win the game, but it's about their competitive efforts tonight. I think they get... have to fight this game right out to the end. They might be overrun by a better side. A highly skilled team has been sensational. But I think so far you'd say they've come really well prepared. They've got some good matchups and they're really having a crack.
Yeah, no doubt. They just need...
shot a goal. It's that easy for the Maggies. Blair gets it from the stoppage.
A little Jared Blair... just found a way there, and that can be disappointing from a boundary throwing structure to allow a fairly cheap goal in the end to the little man, Jared Blair.
Jared Blair getting onto some end of some wonderful ruck work there from Darren Jolly. Pre-planned, set up, and they do that so well, Collingwood.
Yeah, Darren Jolly especially.
So good at the stoppage in their forward 50. I think they were the leaders in the competition in that area last year, if not in the top two. Tuck has been pinged for the throw here. And this will be a Marty Clark free.
Time back on.
Clark on that left boot. Licks the northern side of the ground. Good grab taken by Blair. He's got a very nice set of hands. Cloaks comes deep and wide. He'll now look to pump this into a more attacking position, and he does. Three Collingwood players there. Up they fly. Offhand picked up by Sinclair. And he misses, but they do look dangerous.
A lot of talk about Chris Dawes having to take the second ruck roll, and he just doesn't look comfortable in there, does he? Hasn't done a lot of it before. Well done to Ty Vickery. He always felt if a ruckman came in who didn't know the caper well, and you're able to smash him early, sends a strong message.
Conker goes to the contest. Dawes and Vickery. Out the back, they win the ball. Kick around the corner, hit Jackson on the chest, but wasn't able to gobble it up. And now Shaw around the corner. Vickery had to get a hand on that, just missed it. In there was Batchelor. Martin as well.
Been competitive, Richmond, but a little clumsy. That mark from Dan Jackson, you'd like to think you'd mark that most times. Martin's effort was good, but just a bit clumsy, fell into the back. Collingwood, we're going to make you pay if you make basic errors.
This is within Cloak's range here. He can kick this.
Well, he kicked one from the grand final from this spot, a huge kick. Yep. He started well, Travis Cloak. He's had three inside 50s. He's hitting up well. He's providing options for his halfback and midfielders. He's a very good player.
Not a lot of wind. 52 out, just got it off the instep a little, but he covered the journey very, very easily. Very benign conditions out there tonight, Lingy.
Certainly is. It's perfect conditions for footy, and we're seeing some good quality footy by Collingwood. I'm hoping that Richmond hold their nerve, keep taking the game on. When they're getting the ball to halfway, they've really been quite aggressive in taking the game on. Doesn't matter if they make some mistakes, got to keep taking it up to Collingwood to be in this game.
Hooley plays on, goes out once again for the second time in a row to the contested situation. This time it's Clark, ground level, Tigers bore in and lock it in, and at least call it a nil all draw with the ball up as a good win.
Sorry, mate.
Already they've had to have the five kick-ins, Richmond. Last week they had 17 kick-ins and did not generate one score from those kick-ins, Brian, so it is a problem area.
It is indeed. Trying to work patiently through that here at the moment. Penalty's ball was smothered, went and got it Blair in a ferocious manner, and he was dumped as a result of winning the ball. Here's Foley. great hands to Edwards. Great footwork from Edwards as well. Didn't have a lot of time now. Reed, that half-back. Right in front of the interchange area. Tuvey. Rewalt did well to get a hand. Pendlebury waits for help to arrive. Pushed it out to Clark. Tackled beautifully by Martin. Cochin, sneaky little handball. Need to be clean. They got the right kicker, but Newman kicks it straight to Reed.
And had a couple of shorter options there. Chris Newman, Greg, and also Dustin Martin have pushed forward. So just not the composure the skipper would have liked in that situation.
The spread there for Collingwood is very good, but once again, Tuck, wonderful handball around the corner to Edwards, and Reed will get back again. He's fumbled this, though. Now Keith's really got some hard work to do against Rewalt, and it works for him. Shaw couldn't control that. Or he's got a free kick for too high. Risky kick. They go back inside, Richo.
Yeah, this is a difference. Last year, they were the number one kicking team around the boundary. See them go inboard again there, Brian.
And last week, Richo, they were no longer number one. They were, I think, in the competition.
They were 16th in the first round. So a big change in how they play.
So their game plan has changed from one of boundary to going back inside. Will it work for them? I guess only a season of football will give us the answer to that. Hooley, ball got in the back of Martin. Number one last year for going around the boundary to Collingwood. Last in the competition after one game.
I'm going to catch up with Mick Moldhouse at half-time. We might ask him that exact question. It was a coaching philosophy point of difference between Nathan Buckley and Moldhouse. They're both on the record of saying that they have a different view on that one, Richard.
Yeah, and some people might think by going around the boundary you don't score, but you do. Collingwood were the number one scoring team last year.
Morris to Tuck. Tuck in the Rewalt direction. Reed nurses him under the ball nicely. Edwards with the front and centre ball around the corner. Vickery looks dangerous. Clever little tap. No one there. Tarrant and Pendlebury go at it. Pendlebury tries the difficult kick, cut off, and Miller has taken the mark as a result.
Very rare mistake from Scott Pendlebury in a dangerous situation. He picked the ball up with ease and has put that one straight down the throat of Brad Miller, Richard.
It's been some sloppy kicking from both teams, though, tonight so far. We've seen quite a few of these kicks intercepted by the opposition. Big kick, this one. Richmond, they need to nail this kick.
Brad Miller, just one game away from his 150th. About 35 metres out. There's the angle. A great view of what confronts Miller. Just needs to drop it perfectly, and he has. The Tigers have got their first goal of the night. So Brad Miller getting the first goal through the mistake of Scott Pendlebury, just trying to bite off a little more than he could handle there.
Yeah, we've seen a few of those kicks tonight be chopped off by the opposition. Both teams have already had six clanger kicks each, unlike Scott Pendlebury.
So Richmond get their first goal, and some Carlton onlookers happy to have a look here. Brett Ratton, Paul Williams, Bob O'Reilly, Alan Richardson there. So the whole lot of them having a good, big, solid look.
Big clash next Friday night, that one.
It is indeed, Richo. Carlton play Collingwood Friday night football. Opportunity over the top here. At the moment, the Tigers handball. Big Ivan Marich, don't tell me. Dribble on the ground. And a little bit of a miss. Let's get down to Doc Larkins at the boundary.
Yeah, Brian, your favourite, Jake Push-Up King's gone down the race with the Doc limping heavily. I think it might have been an ankle incident. So Jake King being assessed off the ground, Brian.
Good to see Big Ivan Marich there. He's pushing hard, asking the question of Darren Jolly. Quite able to finish, but it'd be great if he could add that to his game.
Blair. For the Magpies. Steadies things down. Could not be a better night for football here at the G tonight. It's absolutely fantastic condition down the line. This is typical of Collingwood last year, and if they do turn the ball over like that, then it goes into the hands of the boundary umpire, and not a lot of damage done because they're such a good stoppage team. Jolly, the front position on Marich. Cochin. Tuck has a real good knack at keeping the hands free when he's tackled. Tuck. Conker. Tuck, great little give. Grigg. Rewalt's under this, turns his back on it. And Reed will be happy for the boundary line.
Really impressed with their work in tight, Richmond. Foley, Cochin started pretty well. Dustin Martin as well. Their inside midfielders are high quality.
O'Brien along the ground, just trying to get it out of the danger zone. Conker arrives first, though. Shoots the handball off. There's an opportunity once again for Batchelor. Goes inside 50, pack rises. Harry will be happy to see it over the line. Let's get down to Doc again.
Chris Tarrant on the bench, Brian. He's just a little tweak in the right calf. They're just working on him right at the moment, trying to loosen it up. Hopefully it's not too serious, but he's off the ground.
The old man's injury, isn't it? Cotchin around the corner. Jackson, was he held? Side bottom.
Yeah, that's not ideal for Chris Tarrant. First game back in tonight. Brian, a calf injury wouldn't be great for him. And they do say it's the old man's injury when you get the calf, but Taz has got a fair bit of footy left.
He is, I think, the oldest in the Collingwood, on the Collingwood list these days, he and Ben Johnson. Ben Johnson, by the way, playing in the VFL today, did well along with Nathan Brown and, I believe, Sharon Wellingham. So three good players playing in the VFL today. Kick is magnificent to Goldsack. And he marks perhaps right on his capabilities. He plays on top of the square. Great kick to Swan. Getting back is Conker. Didn't get a fist on it. The umpire said he did touch it. So Swan has to go on the left. Around the corner. Missed.
Next Swan, he thought that he'd marked it. He tried the old con job to hold it up, the umpire. He was right there, the umpire, though.
Got the new doozer tonight, Dane Swan.
Yes, just a little bit left on top, but not much on the side stars.
Doesn't like to stand out at all, does he, Swanee?
Unusual character. Deledio to Miller. Tuvey, the night operator. Loves playing at night, Alan Tuvey.
They're really in vogue, those 1950s sort of hairstyles. The Mad Men cut it is from the TV series, Brian.
Is that where it's from, Richo?
You'd be all over that one.
Thank goodness we've got you working tonight. Just bit of spider bait, bit of use of Islam. You've got it all covered. There's no doubt about you. Here's Harry O'Brien through the middle to centre half foot. Great lateral movement there from Cloak. Trying to milk the 50. Now, the next one. Short ball, Swan. A little too far out for him, is it?
If you're a half-back flanker or a midfielder coming through the middle, you just love Travis Cloak, because when you look up, he is always there for that get-out kick leading up at you. And that's what you have to do as a centre-half forward. You have to be in vision of the on-ballers.
Swan gets close to the man on the mark to try and gain the journey here. But as so often happens when you're stretching to get the distance, it always goes left. This is what I like about Richmond. Quick play back in, Richo. Rather than waiting for to set up your structure, just get it back in.
No doubt, that's what you would need to do. If the opposition are allowed to set up, it is very hard to get the ball through. They've been held up here, though. Collingwood have got a good structure in place.
So that's OK. You gave yourself a chance to get it out.
Now you've just got to be patient. And if there's nothing on, you'll have to kick down the line. This is where Jack or Big Marek have to present.
Basha Hooley got to speak one-on-one with Yusuf Islam, formerly known as Cat Stevens, before the game here today. And he insisted on talking to him. He really wanted to have a chat, and we saw some vision where he had a good 5 or 6 minute conversation with the great man.
He did. That would have been a thrill for Basher. I know he wanted to meet him.
Greek back to Grimes.
They're prepared to work it from side to side, Richmond, here. They've had 9 or 10 uncontested marks in a row, and eventually they've been able to get someone out. Just got to hit that target.
Rance again. They dropped Jaden Post last week because of his decision-making, and Rance has got to be a little careful of that as well. There's Blair under the pressure. Swan, let's get down to Doc Larkins.
Yeah, Jake King still downstairs, Brian, having, I think, probably strapping done on his ankle. They're not worried about that, not warming up. Now has the sub. Chris Tarrant still getting work on his calf.
Yeah, that play out of defence, Richo, was absolutely perfect, apart from that final kick from Rance, and the turnover is, again, hurting the Tigers.
Just the execution, Darce, the actual style. They got the style they wanted, but just got to finish it off with the execution.
Grimes here. What do you make of it all so far, Lingy?
I'm seeing a lot of this, BT. Richmond going back and forward, chipping the ball around, and it's all because of Collingwood's structure down the ground. Ben Reid is pretty much doing what he wants. He's standing where he wants to play, setting up the whole Collingwood structure, just giving absolutely no room for Richmond to go anywhere.
Some thoughts from Cameron Ling, the reigning premiership captain. Thomas, handball on. Goldsack winds up from 50 out, missed to the left again. So some poor kicking here in the first quarter, Richo.
Yeah, he's spot on there, Lingy. They were able to hold them up until a bit.
Opportunity here. Conker caught in the tackle. We're told 13 inside 50s each. Sorry, Richo.
Eventually, Richmond had to kick down the line to that contest, and that's where you get the opportunity to win the ball back. They did, and they get a shot on goal for it.
Jolly doing the ruck work. Ivan Maric over the back, just happy to work it to the boundary line. Good win for him, that. He gains 30 metres and gets his side closer to the boundary.
Going back to my point earlier, Brett De Leo has been an enormous player for Richmond across halfback in the last two seasons. I think his evolution as a player is here in the midfield. But as we keep saying, they can't exit defence with any sort of regular consistency. He's their best kick. I think they just have to go back to it.
They just muscle it out like this. This is a classic example of how they get it. And it's, they're sort of hanging on every delivery, aren't you? And in the end, O'Brien's able to work. That wasn't a great kick from O'Brien, and couldn't quite win it underneath Batchelor, but he goes back for a second go. Edwards fast hands to Hooley. Back to Batchelor. Now Edwards again. 60 out. Horrible non-preferred side kick. Ball spills loose. Sinclair went at it. Tuvey there now. Clark and Harry O'Brien combine. And good control to get it to Beams.
I think coaches really go berserk when they feel as though the effort in the game isn't there. We know players try every week, but there's a difference in just how hard you attack the footy. Tonight for Richmond, Damien Harbutt will have no problems at all with that, because they've really come, they're organised, they've cracked in hard. It's just been the skill ever. The skill errors have been horrible.
Kick to Keefe. Not a big scoring quarter of football, this one at the moment. Here's Goldsack. Kicking hasn't been great, both in a field sense or a set shot sense in this first quarter by either side. Cochin gives them a chance. Conker goes inside 50, juggling attempt by Vickery. 15 seconds, a runner would want to get out and tell him. And the runner comes over to him now and says, clock is winding down, do not play on.
And that's the difference. Reece Conker's able to hit that inside 50 kick, forced the turnover there. Well done, Trent Cochin, with a second effort. And found Tyrone Vickery, who's got a chance, you know, to get them back on level terms at quarter time. And I think Damien Hardwick would say, we're playing the style that we want to. We just need to polish the execution, and they'll be right in the game, Dust.
45 career goals for this man here, Ty Vickery. From about 35 metres out, he'll have the distance covered, but he's kicked it to the near side and just the behind. So the poor kicking continues. 1-6-12 to 2-8-20. That man there, you can see the left knee bandage. We'll get a report on him very, very shortly. So a rather benign opening to this one. Collingwood just by 8 points. That man there, the lap of honour at half-time, sitting in the private box here that Collingwood has supplied tonight. And we'll look forward to chatting with him at half-time. It is Collingwood by 8 points at quarter-time.
Obviously, neither team really got full control of that quarter.
Start of the second quarter here at the MCG. Umpires in this game, Dalgleish, Stewart and Meredith. Knocked down to Reid, who did pretty well in that first quarter, as Cameron Ling alluded to. Side bottom thought about the handball, went the kick to Beams. Of course, his brother nominated the NAB Rising Star last week for Brisbane. Ball, a drawing handball to side bottom. Side bottom, good positive attack forward here. Up they fly, big Ivan Maric, nice grab.
Like seeing that, Darcy Ruckman getting back and helping the defence.
Well played, big Ivan, he's shown a bit tonight.
Deledio ran out of room there, Grimes, and Dawes let him know about it.
I think he's done that deliberately. That was well disguised in the end. The umpire didn't thought he was going to fall for that one.
So Richmond kicking to the right of screen here in this second quarter. Jolly and Maric. Beautiful double-handed knockdown. Swan around the corner. Once again, they win that stoppage cleanly. Just the execution of the kicking skill that didn't get it done for them. Cochin, high ball. Foley attacks it and marks nicely. Umpire rightly calling, not 15. Martin forced to move it. Just able to get rid of the Swan tackle. Bit of composure around the corner, although it has been intercepted by Seedsman. Now, here's the sub that's been activated for Chris Tarrant. High ball. Dawes is there. Interrupted in his run over the back for Solo. Couldn't get on the end of it. Received the handball now for Solo. Dragged to ground in the tackle. Got rid of the handball, said the umpire.
Let's have a look at this stoppage here. Dane Swan, he's a genius at hitting the stoppage with a bit of pace, and he got goal side of Trent Cotchin. You've got to be very careful there with Dane Swan. He loves getting on the move at stoppages.
Grigg. In the end, Seedsman was dragged down by one arm. Surely didn't dispose of it correctly. The umpire said no legal disposal. Correct call. Delidio. Short ball, Newman.
Thanks, Dane.
Most possessions of either side on the ground at the moment. This man here, Chris Newman. His 11th touch. Alexa Southern side. Finds Rance. Now, they need to get to Rance for handball. He's one guy they probably don't necessarily want all the time kicking it. This time, he does well to Morris. Morris around the corner. Grigg shielding his eyes from the lights. Penn will be able to tidy it up. Clark and Reed involved as well. Back to Pendlebury on his non-preferred side. Good kick to Dawes. Dawes along the boundary to Cloak. Not much deep. Getting back in position now is Payne. It comes in his direction. Newman's a smaller body but did really well with the front position for the Tigers.
Been keeping an eye on Jack Riewoldt, whose matchup is Ben Reed. There you see Ben Reed at least 30 metres behind Riewoldt. He's playing it really smart. Riewoldt's working hard, but he's getting caught out of position a lot with Reed just sagging off and that blocking up the dangerous space.
Once again, Newman in the thick of it.
Come out! And the five or back on the
trying
mark.
To skip up. Grimes.
Jack's probably going to need to present for this one here. Darce down the line, but Richmond have been really keen to switch this all night and they have again.
And they've been incredibly patient. Here's Brandon Ellis. Just wonder how long they can remain in this frame of mind before they start taking unnecessary risks and fatigue gets them. Brandon Ellis with a long ball in the marriage direction off hands.
It reminds me a lot, BT, of the Ross Lyon coach St Kilda teams who've got defenders back there. It was Zach Dawson, Jason Blake, who play a bit this way. They're not necessarily highly skilled, but they didn't ever take a kick that was going to be a risky one. They held on to possession. They chipped the short ball. Worked very effectively for them.
Tuck had the ball knocked out of his hands. That's why it wasn't paid. A free kick. Here's Swan. Got Sinclair on the inside for support. Swan goes to the top of the square. Dawes backing back. Almost one glove. In the end, tidied up by Batchelor. Risky kick up the middle. Comes off to Conker. Tigers should gun it and go here. Clear possession on the wing. Brandon Ellis. He's lovely by foot. Boy from the Calder Cannons Footy Factory out wide and he lets me down as Reed got a paw on it.
There it is again, Ben Reed reading the play beautifully. But your call was spot on, BT. They've got to get the balance right as well. When they do get an opportunity to go quick, then they've got to take their risk. That's their opportunity to score on a slow play. Happy for them to hold on to it. But that was an occasion which they could have really taken off and used it a bit better.
Yeah, Ben Reed reads the ball off the opposition boot better than anyone. He's so good at those intercept marks. On that occasion, got in and punched the ball off. Jack Riewoldt nearly got out the back of him, but he reads it so well.
Side bottom boot, the ball was good, and Rance defensively strong. So a real game of chess here at the moment. Good kick by Rance, finds Grigg. Grigg desperate to go, no runners on either side of him, so he has to turn his back and front the leading forwards now. Vickery offers something, ignores that, and now goes high into that contest. Vickery there in front of Miller. Off hands, Edwards, quick snap around the corner. And I think he may have got it, he has.
No one against the flow of play there for Shane Edwards from the Tigers. They're at the front and centre very, very nicely indeed, that man there on screen. And reward for effort. They've controlled the footy for the first 4 or 5 minutes of the second term. And Nathan Buckley all of a sudden with just a little frown on his forehead.
Did really well here, Shane Edwards. Tyrone Vickery did what he needed to do as the tall player. And if you're not going to mark the ball, you must bring it to the front. And Shane Edwards timed it beautifully for the front and square and a good finish around the corner.
Merritt is going to have the wind knocked out of him there. He will be winded. He gets back up. Strong, the big man, as Batchelor in defence.
Great effort from Merritt to get back up. It was an accidental tunnel from Jolly, and that's the basketball term where you get someone's legs from underneath. In fact, it was Ivan who really put himself in that situation, so nothing untoward, but She hit his head hard.
It's a horrible feeling being tunnelled, that's for sure. It's one of the worst feelings.
Well, in basketball, it's a technical foul. Yeah. It's one of the worst things you can do.
And Jolly didn't do it on that occasion.
No.
But that feeling of having your legs taken out from under you when you're in the air, not very good at all.
Bashahuli here in defence. Once again, Richmond go into this sort of time-effective strategy of slowing things down and spreading nicely to give themselves opportunity to find easier kicks. Tells Rance to play on, kicks down the line looking for Foley. Precise it is.
He makes me nervous, Alex Rance. He pulled that one off, but just think he might have the old Mick Martin from North Melbourne rule. Just kick it as far as you can.
Pendlebury over the top, good grab. You can see it right in front of the interchange area. Pendlebury goes long, but Cloak's got to beat a couple. And
that's why you love him, because he's just so honest and so brave, Richo. He put his body on the line every time for Alex Rance.
No doubt about that. That's why they love him. He's very brave. He puts his head over the football.
They've got the overlap here, the Tigers, but they've got to keep going. Conker. Someone needed to present up, and no one did. Vickery should have come at him. And now he goes to a risky one in the middle. Deledio made the kick look better than it was. Morris had great use of the hand. On to Hooley. He should have banged it on the left. They crack in the Tigers. High tackle by Shaw. This will be a Richmond free to Newman. 70 metres out, Chris Newman. Jack offers something. That is ignored over the top, and now Daniel Jackson.
Richmond have taken 9 intercept marks now off the Collingwood boot, and it's been one of those games for both teams. Just haven't been able to hold onto the ball for any great period of time. And that's why we haven't seen many scores tonight, because it's been chopped off by the opposition.
Daniel Jackson for the first Richmond lead from 55, and he's missed it by an absolute mile. Lockie Keefe and Dawes both getting fists and hands on the ball.
Let's go back to that last centre bounce. Here's Big Ivan. He goes up, he goes down.
And he's done well to get straight back up.
He bounced straight up, Big Ivan. Good effort.
That would have knocked a couple of buckets of wind out of his guts. Gold sack around the corner. Little handball there by Fasolo. Dawes, the given shepherd. Handball to himself, Thomas almost. Ran out of tarmac.
Stay out of it.
Haven't seen much of Thomas so far in this game. Just the 3 touches. Vickery deliberately making contact. Did well against ball. Here's Jolly now and Beams. Beams nurses the little left side kick down to Fasolo. Very funny game. Crowd not involved at the moment.
Yeah,
because
it's just there's not a lot happening in the crowd, because both teams are playing this way at the moment.
We saw attacking footy in round one from just about every team in the competition. And what we're seeing here at the moment, as Darce has mentioned several times, is the complete opposite. St Kilda style of the last few years. Here's Cloak. Rants again. This is the part of the game he's good at. Now the little man King. He's a bubble of muscle. Got it on to Martin. Can they break them open here? Jackson. Nothing to kick to. Has to go to the contest. Miller. And side bottom. Did well, Miller. At the back, Clark, Harry O'Brien. Now on the counter, Collingwood. Pendlebury. Gets it off to Keefe.
Be disappointed there, Brad Miller. He had his 2 hands on the football. He bodied up well. Just couldn't quite hold the mark.
Blair and Swan combining. I tell you what, Richmond at the moment, we don't know how good they're going to be this year. We know that Collingwood were good last year. Richmond are bringing this game back to them, aren't they?
That's exactly what it feels like at the moment. They've been able to just change the momentum of this game a little bit.
That's not being disparaging of the Tigers. It's simply they haven't been great over the last couple of years. In fact, last 30 years. Here is Travis Cloak with a wonderful kick. Travis Cloak with an enormous kick there. And the fans a little happier as a result of that.
Let me know when you are going to be disparaging the Tigers, BT. They haven't been good for 30 years. It's probably reasonable statement.
I
knew exactly what you meant.
Yes.
8-point lead is to the Magpies, 1 against the flow.
Well, here he is, Travis Cloak.
It's the Rucks.
He's a powerful man. That was a nice finish. But they got the overlap over the ground there. What his opponent, you can see Alex Rance behind him, disappointed. But Alex had to do the right thing there and come off his man. That left Travis free inside 50.
The clearance for the Pies out of the middle beams. Sinclair, Blair, can he shake the tackle? Batchelor made it stick. Good stuff. Collision. Cochin. Bashahuli. Sneaky handball to Tuck. Tuck, a nice little nursing kick out to Jack.
We saw Jack present up to the wing there. His man, Travis Reed, is where Jack wants to kick. Ben Reed is where Jack wants to kick to now. That's why he's had to go short.
Tuck, who has a high ratio of handball to kicks, understands where his game is at.
Question we're asking tonight in the world of Twitter. Who would you like out there? Our man, Richo, who kicked over 880 goals. Or Jack Revolt, Brian?
Yes, well, you jump onto Twitter and you can do that.
Oh, what a great contest that was.
Seedsman getting knocked there. And as a result, we see a blood rule.
Cochin's ability to come out of the most contested situation with the footy on a regular basis is why we think he's going to be a superstar, Richard.
Oh, no doubt about that. Just watching it. Gee, players are brave now. They just, whenever it is their turn to go, they put their head over the football. Never been braver AFL players. Used to be able to get away with a few things in footy, but now everything is so scrutinised, the players are so tough, always put their head over the footy.
Rance. Grimes. Through the hands of Jackson, Clark able to tidy it up. Here they go, Collingwood with the overlap runner. Shaw can go wide. Got a man loose out there at the moment. Nicely done in Siegeman. Didn't take Newman on. Went back inside to Swan. Swan got the runner in Sinclair and he marks inside the arc. Ben Sinclair. From just beyond 50, almost beyond the blue line by the time he completes his approach. He's looking inside, nothing there. Sinclair from 51 out.
Something wrong with his football tonight, I think. This kick here from Alex Rance, he just tried to bite off a little bit too much. Daniel Jackson is in the middle of four Collingwood players there. I reckon in that situation, if you're going to a 50-50, you're better off making it a long 50-50, because that was just too much.
Hooley, high ball, Marich in front, good mark.
Been impressive tonight, Ivan.
Look at the close-up of those eyes. It's hard to see from that shot, but he's got eyes that pierce right through you. Here's Jack Rewalt. Rewalt wide. Conker. Over the top to Tuck. Once again, methodically trying to work their way forward here. The Tigers. Tuck inside 50. One-on-ones everywhere. Keefe. And over the line, Thomas.
Fairly strange sort of game tonight. Let's get down to Cameron Ling. How are you seeing it down there, Ling?
I'm seeing with the way Richo just mentioned that we're trying to kick the ball to a 50-50. There's no 50-50 because Collingwood have got an outnumber by two or three at times going forward because Richmond players are just living up the ground trying to get easy kicks. They've got to go and engage the Collingwood defenders to make it even numbers, make it a contest.
Bad fumble by Butch. Batchelor in the middle, but he got some support in Grimes. Collingwood now picked up here by Payne. Payne inside 50, couldn't find the target. Needs a good bounce, Batchelor. They come at him. He won't find the boundary line, or will he? Seedsman keeps it alive. So the Tigers are going to defend again. Side bottom just got the handball away from a desperate Tuck. Well done, Tuck. Brandon Ellis. Martin with some really good body work on O'Brien then. Look at the awareness to get the handball off. Brilliant play. Rewalt caught. The Tigers push their way forward. Ball clobbers him in the tackle and got him forward. Cochum's free.
Well, you called it, BT. That play from Dustin Martin on the wing has set up this opportunity to go inside 50. Great contested ball.
Cochin to the lead. Never looked like they needed to go fat side. Picked up by Jack. He's got his eyes set on the goal. You can see he wanted to turn it around. Missed. And the minor score. So 2-7 for Richmond.
As you said, Richard, have a look at the strength of a second-year player amongst seasoned hard bodies to just work his way through. Unbelievable.
Blair has given two chances to get rid of it, then he got caught, Richo.
Let's not take anything away from the pressure out there tonight. Both teams 11 Clanger kicks Collingwood, 9 Richmond, but there is some pretty good pressure like that.
Deledio to Jake King. Also there, Rewald. Edwards, did he throw it? The umpire said he threw it. And a free kick Collingwood's way. Yeah, just get the feeling at the moment the Tigers are rising to the occasion.
Yeah, I like what they've brought to the table tonight, BT. It's been a really strong, determined game plan that they have come and really put their bodies on the line so far. A few skill errors have let them down, but their intent and aggression has been great.
Tuck to Batchelor. Along the ground, wasn't a great kick. Jackson tried to take him on. Clark got him in the tackle. Ball's desperate, but Cotchen was better. Look at him try to bully his way out of there. Really well done, Cotchen, to set up the Martin opportunity that he misses.
I asked a question before on Twitter. Is it our man Richo or Jack Rewald? Landslide, BT.
Is it?
Richo's
our
way.
Man.
They want him out there again.
I had absolutely nothing to do with that question, which is a ridiculous question. It's Jack Rewald every day of the week.
Yeah, there's no doubt about it, Richo. You are the people's choice when it comes to all things, anything.
It's just ridiculous, Brian.
Reed. Getting back. Morris. Blair's there, Rance did well. Now there's a 2-on-1 in favour of the Pies. Morris, Deledio, under the pump. Rance took ball on, nowhere to go. Was it deliberate? Yes, it is.
Thank you.
Ball with a quick one inside to Cloak, and Cloak marks.
And that's his opponent, Travis Cloak, so... pretty stiff there. In modern footy, when you get the football and you look up, Alex Rance, great effort by Luke Ball to shut him down, but I think that's pretty conclusive. It was deliberate. So while he's on the ground, Travis Cloak, smart forward, takes the opportunity to duck out the back.
Cloak kicked the last Collingwood goal at the 11-minute mark of this quarter. We're now entering the 19-minute mark, and Cloak comes in and drills the goal. That's as straight as they come. So Travis Cloak getting it over the line. His second consecutive goal there for the Pies. And the Pies now by 12 points. You just get the sense, just starting to open up a little bit, isn't it?
Yeah, you always have a strong feeling that the momentum in their class is going to be with Collingwood, which makes this last 5.5 minutes very important.
Well, he's happy with that, Travis Cloak. He's had his critics with his goal kicking over the years. Kicked 2 goals tonight, and he's actually looked a little bit more polished than a lot of other players on the ground tonight. He's had a good night. 9 possessions, 6 inside 50s, 2 goals. Doing his job, Travis Cloak.
Just repeating the news, Chris Tarrant is out of this game. Appears to be some sort of leg muscle strain on the left side, whether it's calf up to the hamstring. Doc Larkin's reporting on that earlier. So he has been subbed out, and the sub has been activated in Siegeman. Here's Dawes. Dawes is probably the biggest big man kick they've got in the Pies. From 55 metres out, launches a long ball offline.
What a dangerous 5 minutes and 20 seconds remaining in the second half here. It just feels as though starting to break away from stoppage is a little bit stronger than they have done in the past. And really need to hang on here, Richmond. They've been brave. They don't want to go in with a bigger lead at halftime.
Big halftime coming up. Collingwood supporters get the opportunity for the tribute to Mick Malthouse. A lap of honour here. We'll have him mic'd and look forward to speaking directly with the man that has taken his 3 teams to, I think, 8 grand finals in total. The second most games coached ever in the history. Here's Beams. Little bit of an iffy give. Swan with that scooter-style running action. Got it to Shaw. Sold the foot candy on Alice. Drills the kick to Blair.
With the last 2 kicks inside 50 for Collingwood. The one to Dawes from Luke Ball and that one there to Jared Blair were precise. They just picked up their foot skills, but that was created by Dane Swan. He waited for the right opportunity to release Heath Shaw. He showed some poise, and I said it was a great kick. It had a bit of inside-out torpy about it, but it found its target.
Blair preferring to spin the ball on his approach, get a good feel on it. 45 out, just a little bit of angle about it. His teammates like it, he likes it. Collingwood, three consecutive goals. Collingwood by 19 points. Clearances 11-2. Centre clearances 3-1. Second quarter here.
Just got right on top in this quarter in that situation you're talking about, BT.
Starting to open them up there. Richo, Pendlebury out of the middle. Cloak was being held by Rance. Now he's in range
back
here.
In fact,
it'll go the Richmond way, will it? It will. Go to Rance.
And this is where Alex Rance... He's just got to learn to make smart choices and just take the conservative approach. Pick up a kick like that.
Well, that's his kick every time, isn't it?
Should be.
Yep. Kick out wide and made it look good in the end. Deledio onto Grigg. Bit of speed through the middle. Conker not able to glove the ball cleanly. It was slightly behind him.
High. Toovey.
Alan Toovey's ball, high tackle, said the umpire. Toovey to Pendlebury. Didn't have that peripheral vision to see what was coming from behind. The advantage is paid to Jackson. Jackson goes deep to Miller. He had his man beaten on the lead, and they couldn't get it cleanly to him.
How good Trent Cotchin there, Richo. He's having a rest forward. He's just in the game every time the ball's in his vicinity. Ran hard, chased down, and set up another opportunity to go inside 50, but a poor kick let them down again.
Block, Richmond.
Richmond free. Let's have a listen.
He's trying to contest the ruck. You're holding him back. He's looking to contest the ruck. He can't stand and block him.
So the Collingwood players are saying that Vickery is not the ruckman. I think he was the ruckman on that occasion.
I think they were trying to con the umpire. Yeah. He was the only ruckman there. I thought I heard someone say Rewalt's in the ruck, but he was nowhere near the contest.
Yep.
Correct decision.
I agree. Vickery, as a result, only 35 metres out, stuttery run up, kick, coming, not enough. 2.09 for the Tigers.
Well, they're going to rue these chances at half-time. Dustin Martin missed a pretty easy goal before, and Tyrone Vickery, that one there. You can't keep giving Collingwood chances, because in the end, they will make you pay. They're such a good team. Got to make the most of these easy opportunities.
1.03, the Tigers. Set shots here tonight. Thomas over the back. Goldsack involved, and the Magpies just working off half back. This time the kick wasn't fantastic. Grigg. Little ball, Newman.
This is where you think you'd like to be able to catch Collingwood out, because you've broken one up in the middle of the ground. This is the time where you actually take a risk. You're halfway down the middle of the ground. Play on. Get it in there quickly.
Big Darren Jolly's got back there and clogged it up. Just needs to go to a contest.
A little loopy ball back inside. Pendlebury's able to get back. Almost a mark in the middle there. Here it comes to Cotchin. Got to get around Jolly. Can take him on. Great poison control from Cotchin to find Miller on the lead.
He has been enormous, Trent Cotchin. Disposal number 13 there. But it just stands out the class. Look at his awareness. I love players who just back their leg speed and take the game on. Broke open the play. The finish was just sensational. Almost forced Brad Miller to lead there.
Well, just all class.
I think he looked there and thought, it's Darren Jolly. I know that I can get around him. That's what the good players do. Mark Murphy does that so well. They make the right decisions at the right time.
This is a must goal here for the Tigers. Minute and a half to go before the halftime break, and another miss.
Well, that destroys you, that does. Just kills your confidence, knocks you around, and you really need reward for that effort.
Ball to O'Brien. Cloak on the wing. Just over a minute remaining here in the half. Fasola the target. He's got Beams running for him, ignores that. Now what does he do? Beams comes a second time. And there was a nice little gap right opened up there for him.
He's on it. You're on your angle.
Now, Beams, you can see him creeping around to lessen the angle. Now, the umpire should just simply call play on that situation, I reckon. He's come around, I reckon, four steps when he said from when he said you're on the angle.
Smart play. He's got himself, as you said, three or four extra metres on the angle, which makes a big difference.
And watch him straight line this now rather than go back to where he was.
Good shot at goal normally.
So Beams, kick on the way. Nice looking ball. Touched off hands.
I want the Sheringham inspector down there at half time to ask, is something wrong with this football?
He's genuine floaters tonight.
And conditions are just absolutely perfect. So, what the reasoning for that is. You can't check it, Richo.
There's no wind at all, is there? It's a perfect night for footy.
Bashahuli, although you do have the trick, the book on all the excuses for kicking.
Is that
don't you? Is that one of the ones you had in your...
That was. The footy's checked at halftime.
Siren sounds to complete the half. It's a low-scoring affair, but it is the Magpies by 18 points here at halftime. And they lead it 5-10-40 to Richmond 2-10-22. On the other side of the break, Mick Malthouse gets a chance here in front of the fans to say well done on coaching Collingwood to that premiership.
Going on here as we go to the break. Ivan and Jolly going for it. He's got the mad stare going, Ivan.
He has. He's got a pair of eyes that you just would not even bother going near in a nightclub. I can tell you now, just getting a little bumpy and a little pushy here. Starting to boil over there. Rance going at it. This is going to open up. Jolly's in there now. This is erupting here at the MCG. Players from both sides coming in. Dawes is in the middle. Blairs is there with a little left hook as well. And it is absolutely on here at the MCG.
And who's on the bottom? Jake King's on the bottom. Shane Tuck handles himself well. Don't worry about that.
Tuck and Beams are going at it. Little fracas breaking out everywhere here now. Umpires have come back from the tunnel. They were down the tunnel and gone. And the umpires have had to come back on the ground.
Have a look at the push-up King. He went straight for Darren Jolly, the biggest man on the ground. He had him in a sleeper hold. Have a look at push-up.
That's just a normal Friday night out Coburg way, Dust.
You got to love it.
So Jake King's all fired up. The Tigers have got their supporters fired up. And the Magpies here at the moment lead at halftime by 18 points.
No surprises that when that pack sort of dissipated out, Jake King was on the bottom of it.
Start of the second half of football here, Collingwood at halftime by 18 points. Grigg out of the middle. Thomas breaks away, gets a good look at it from 50 metres out, launches a long ball. Collingwood inside 15 seconds. Thomas gets the break and capitalises for the Pies.
That's always a fear with the class and the quality that Collingwood have got out in the field. Seen a lot of Dale Thomas so far in this game, but has the capacity to do this. And look, if they get going, Richo, they can really blow this one apart in the second half.
No doubt. Well, neither team's been able to get going, and you sense that from Daisy, that he's got himself going now. He's had a reasonably quiet night. He got on the end of that, but that's fantastic. They're game breakers, guys that can be 80-metre players like Daisy Thomas there, running through 50 and kicking goals. Fantastic play from Daisy.
Get down to Doc in a moment and get a update on those injuries as well. There's been a few of them here in this game, as there have been in others. Thomas around the corner with a high ball. Down the Dawes direction. Sinclair's taken the mark in front of Morris. 55 metres out, no thought of the goal. Centre of the ball, here comes Cloak. Got the run over the top. He's the best contested mark in the competition. Doesn't let them down.
Travis Knox here.
That was a great set-up kick coming in there. They can see his teammates congratulating him there, Sinclair. That was fantastic kick to the fat side. Travis Cloak got separation off his opponent, Alex Rance. And when he has the ability to run and jump at the ball, as you can see here, You can't stop that. He's 6'5" and he's a huge man. If he can get a jump at the football, he will mark it every day of the week.
Bit of grass in the air, Matthew Lloyd style there as Cloak comes in to kick his third goals. This is a dynamic Collingwood start.
Come out and just go on bang, bang, the Magpies, and Nathan Buckley takes a little sip of the water and able to relax a little bit. A bit more stress for Damien Hardwick. Well, I think at halftime would have been fairly comfortable with how competitive they were, but this is a juggernaut, the Collingwood Football Club, and big start in the second half.
Collingwood by 30 points. Let's get down to Doc and get a bit of an injury update. Doc, I noticed some taping to the shoulder of Cloak.
No, he's just kicked a great goal, but if you get a great time we have a look, you'll see he had an injection during the second quarter for a knock on the shoulder. He's got strapping on the right calf from a knock, and he's still kicking goals, and he's going well. Tarrant out of 20-minute mark, out for the rest of the game, and Nate Foley with a broken nose, he's back out there.
Plenty happening in the injury front down there with Doc Larkins. Penalty's got a free here in the middle. And Collingwood sideways to Thomas. So they'll try and pick their way through this zone that Richmond have set up. Kick comes in long at the back of the pack. Couldn't get it there, Siegesman. Sinclair around the corner, high ball. Jackson getting back, and Rance, they collide. It was absolutely odds on, wasn't it?
You.
In the end, Batchelor able to tidy things up just a little. Shaw plays on, centering ball. This will be punched away. Jake King tried to extend those little midget arms, but they didn't reach. Deledio to Ellis. Tuvey. Left foot. More intensity needed from Ellis. Marking the goal square by Thomas. Just reckon Brandon Ellis needed to stick at the contest there.
BT, Dale Thomas starting in the middle of the ground has just charged forward each time and been involved in all three of these goals for Collingwood.
And as a result, Lingy kicks his second goal of the quarter. And a whistle here. Umpire's going to give it all the clear.
It would have been 50 if that wasn't a goal for throwing your mouthpiece up. OK.
Six consecutive goals. Let's have a listen to this.
Don't throw your mouthpiece up. You
should
be
50. Okay, so the goal hadn't have been kicked, he would have been given another one for throwing the mouth guard up in the air.
I haven't heard that before, BT. It is unique. Throw the mouth guard up and get penalised.
Yep. Six consecutive goals for the Magpies. Pendleby with a clearance out of the middle to go with it. Up they fly. Dawes won't be paid the mark. Offhand set the umpire. The call was clear. Fasolo turns around. Off one step. Seven consecutive goals. Four in this quarter. Collingwood on an absolute roll here at the moment. This quarter's only been going 5 minutes and 20 seconds and already four goals in the quarter.
Four goals in under 5 minutes to start the second half. Fasolo gets involved. And now it comes back to the Tigers and their leaders, Richo. They've got to just slow this game down, maintain possession for a little bit.
Well, they haven't even had it in their forward half yet, Darce. This will be their first time.
Yeah, well, they've hardly had any possession in this half of footy. I'm not sure, Richo, what possession they've had in this quarter here at the moment, but it would not be a lock. A lock as Beams takes the mark.
It's 13-7. Collingwood have kicked four goals. That's efficiency at its best.
Four goals out of 13 possessions.
So three possessions a goal at the moment, Collingwood.
It's fantastic. Ball off hands. Blair, the perfect front and centre, wasn't it? Kevin Bartlett style for those old-timers watching. And here's Travis Cloak. Too far out for him to score. Cloak to the top of the square.
Top of the 50.
An opportunity here for Solo. Did he use the body illegally? The umpire said no.
Did it beautifully. And we spoke about Alex Solo before. He's playing on a young player and only his second game, but he's only played 14 games himself. He has the ability to take marks and get the ball at ground level.
5 goals in 6 minutes in the quarter for the Magpies.
Just gave a little bit after the goal there, Alex Masolo. Stephen Morris, the umpire, suggesting, mate, you might want to just hold on to that. The free kick will come your way.
Point margin now, Collingwood lead.
Fantastic play there by Tyson Goldsack, just to hold his opponent out, allow Fasolo to take a one-on-one mark. Fantastic team play by Goldsack.
Fasolo having a little bit of a giggle there, just how easy it was.
He's pretty happy with it. Richmond have put a loose behind the ball now to try and stem the bleeding.
Deledio, they just need to get possession of the ball, but Collingwood aren't going to let them do that. Pendlebury with a kick wide to Seedsman. Seedsman in game 2. Very wide, great kick. Good mark under enormous pressure. Cloak, and he says to Rance, get out of my way.
I'm just wasting your time, mate. I'm wasting your time. There's no need for it. You took a dive as well, Alex.
Getting well on top now, Travis Cloak.
The umpire.
Not sure why the umpire stopped him playing on then. He had no right to do it if he wasn't going to award a free kick
him. I'll give a bit both ways. I'm going to slow you down and you took a dive.
That's just not on. 55 metres out, a lovely kick. It'll fall short, up they fly. No winner in the air. Batchelor, Deledio, combining with Grigg. Tigers try to work it out. Here's Morris. They get it to the wing. Get the feeling. Good mark taken by King. Ground giving him a bit of the Bronxies here tonight. Loves the brawl, does our Jake. Back inside, Martin. Through traffic, Edwards, fast hands, Grigg. Vickery, Bashahuli, inside 50, lets it rip to the punt right in. They desperately need a goal.
I know Bashahuli is a good finisher, but he actually had Chris Newman 5 metres to his left, who had no pressure on him whatsoever. He could have straightened up and run into goal.
Even before that, Richard, I think if you were forward, impossible to get any read on what was going on there. There was about 8 handballs in a row. And as you looked up, Jack Ruvott was out and Dan Jackson were both out. Someone had to pull the trigger and kick it, and they would have been able to score.
See that, the way they come up and support each other on the mark there.
Unintentional, mate.
A nice shepherd
in front, and you're playing from getting to the footy, mate.
Here's Riewoldt.
There's the difference on disposal going inside 50. Jack Riewoldt had a metre on his opponent there, the ball just bouncing in front of him. But just been watching Travis Cloak. The work he does off the ball before he eventually gets possession, it's huge.
47-point margin here. Vickery over the top. Greek in amongst it. Trying to extract it is Tuvey. Richmond fight the fight here and lock it inside their 50.
Thanks,
let's have a look at this for a kick-in. Marty Clark goes there. Have a look at the man come up in support. Harry O'Brien knows he's going to get a shepherd here. Bang. Able to play on.
That's a set play, BT. Does that a lot, Harry O'Brien.
That is just perfectly executed planning. Here's Foley. Swans in amongst it. Jolly wasn't too keen to take the ball out of there, but thought the tackle was almost a little high on Grigg there as well as he tries to crawl out.
This little patch, BT and Richo, to start the second half is very characteristic of why Collingwood have been a great side. They have always had this 10-minute burst in the last 2, so where they blow sides out of the water, and we saw that 5 goal in 6 minutes, which has really put Richmond right behind the eight ball.
Foley doing well. Clark with the win in there in the end, and Tuvey's wrapped up in the Grigg tackle.
Holding the ball.
And
you had it with one arm free, and you didn't make a genuine attempt.
So there it is.
One arm free.
Umpire
must make a genuine attempt,
Simon and Meredith saying no genuine attempt there from Tuvey. The resultant free kick will go the Tigers' way.
Not sure I've seen a more efficient 5 goals either in terms of disposal. They just went bang, averaging about 5 disposals per goal.
A little bit going on there with Jack Ruvall, Scotty Pendlebury, a little bit of lip
Some quiet words there. Quite funny when you see penalty chatting with Riewoldt. Here is Greg. There's a look at it. And they have been terrible in this position tonight. 2-12 as the Richmond supporters wonder what is going on.
It's amazing how when a couple of players miss, the pressure builds on the whole team, and every person that steps up to have a set shot feels that pressure, and the whole team has the yips at the moment.
Their last goal, in fact, coming the Tigers at the 5-minute mark of the second quarter.
Shane, thank you.
That was from Edwards. O'Brien gets the run from Shaw. Shaw playing that role that Leon Davis played so well last year. Deepish defender that likes to get on the end of it and distribute it. Good punch away from Morris. Did well. Riewoldt. Goal sacking there. Morris got one high.
He's a hard nut, Stephen Morris, isn't he?
Plays on with a handball out to Foley. Foley goes inside 50. Swan, big mark over the top.
Thank you.
Seedsman. Yep. Nice grab by Dane Swan. Don't often see him elevating as the third or fourth man up in the contest. That was lackadaisical. And Morris just getting a little attention there. Looks okay. Think he'll continue.
Six, slow down, one, six. Push out, five. Six, come back to me, buddy.
Cotchin.
Tough kick this one here now. Collingwood have got numbers behind the ball.
Thanks,
just got to be patient. Dane Swan and Harry O'Brien.
See the pattern of play here. Here is Alice. Goes wide with a kick. Still the ball hung too long in the air there. It gave Goldsack time to run it down defensively. Thomas, Batchelor. Here comes Tuvey. Alice nice and hard at the ball. Batchelor with the win to conquer. Good in close play here. Morris got it to Tuck. Tuck goes to the Riewoldt. One-on-one with Reed, had him tied up. Lockie Keefe, the big man, front and centre. The Shepherd against Riewoldt, allowing Reed to Swan, to Tuvey. And eventually the boundary line will win out.
Saw another turnover there. It was Brandon Ellis kicking the footy sideways to Stephen Morris. That's 2 second gamers playing in defence for Richmond. And you can only go with the cattle that you've got. But when your issue is kicking defensively, and then you throw 2 second gamers back there who just haven't got the composure and the experience. I keep saying it, but I just think they need some support. They need a leader back there. The obvious one is Brett Delidio, but he can't allow Christian Inman to do it all. They've got to put some quality back in defence and give these young players a bit of a chop out.
O'Brien and Morris did well. Hallie O'Brien to Fasolo. Got around one, far too easy. Fasolo just pulls the kick a little. Dawes came out, it couldn't gobble it up. And now Marich and Allison Foley combined. Got them on the counter here, the Tigers. Ball use needs to be good. Had to go sideways, had nothing on down the field. And Jackson, but now into the slow play.
Dustin, then you throw Grimes and Batchelor into the mix, the other two defenders tonight. And they've played less than 15 games each as well. So
Jackson with a beautiful front and centre. Clean ball. He's kicked it to a two-on-one and Pauly. Swan. Tuvey can get it and go. Decides against it. Nahas, who's the sub that's been activated for the Tigers. Let's get down to Lingy.
You're right, BT. The sub has been activated. Stephen Morris, the man to come off. And Robbie Nahas is on to add a little bit of speed through the Richmond midfield.
Side bottom to Thomas. Alice is in there. They'll fight for it. Will he be penalised?
Dale Thomas' burst to start the second half has really blown this game apart. Saw him involved in the first three goals, kicked two of them himself. But look at him working off the ball there, just constantly on the move. Cleaned up Dustin Martin on his way through.
Jackson. Nicely disguised. So let's just have a look at this quarter here. 5 goals for Collingwood kicked in the opening 6 minutes of the quarter. And now a lead of 46 points. At the start of the quarter, it was just 18.
Push, stop Pendlebury. Collingwood stop. Against Dustin Martin, pushing the back.
You heard the umpire explain that.
Coming up to possession number 21, Scott Pendlebury.
Ball to O'Brien. It'll be cut off by Cochin. It's been one positive point for the Tigers. A bounce. He's looking for some support runners. Riewoldt had to go back. He does. Nicely to Deledio. Lets it rip from 50 to an open goal square. That's what they need, and they get it through their superstar, Deledio.
At the moment, the Tigers rely really heavily on their handful of guns, and this man is a gun, Trent Cochin. Riewoldt's another one, and then Deledio. Their three of their four better players get involved. The result, a goal to the Tigers.
Out of the middle here. Swan with a little dribbler for Solo. He's very clean at ground level for Solo. Absorbs the punishment. Beams. Tuvi. Handball out wide. And Beams again. This time finds Thomas. Thomas lets it rip. There's the sixth Collingwood goal of the quarter. Thomas, three goals here in this third quarter, has simply been dynamic. After, I must say, a relatively quiet first half of football by Thomas standards, and he takes a bit of a breather. Well-earned rest for him. Dale Thomas, dynamic.
Fair quarter for Dale Thomas. Six disposals, three clearances, three goals. Has blown this game right apart, superstar Richard. I've just loved watching the way he's evolved as a player. Gone in the last two or three seasons to an out-and-out champion.
Back inside 50 again, out of the middle. This time taking it away is Grimes. Been a sub in this game, Lingy.
It has. I have to correct myself, boys. I apologise. A fair bit of confusion on the bench. It's actually Jake King who's come from the ground as the sub. Stephen Morris is still involved.
Of course, he got injured very early in the game and appears not to have recovered for that. Go down the dock in a minute and find out what that injury was. Here is Cloak around the corner with a high ball. They fly. And for the grab over the back. No one behind. Swan runs into an open goal. Went the dribbler and missed. Let's get down to Doc Larkins and just find out what that injury was for Jake King. Doc.
Yeah, Brian, it was 15 minutes into the first quarter he hurt the medial ligament. They strapped him up and played, and about 4 minutes ago, Brian, he got trapped again and he tweaked the left knee again, so they've subbed him out and he's heavily iced up sitting in the back row with a red vest on.
Hey, Doc, just recap, the Chris Tarrant injury went off few minutes of the game.
Yeah, probably a high calf injury just where the Achilles starts, so that's a three-weeker, and it happened 20 minutes in the first quarter there.
Gee, that's not a good start for Chris Tarrant, is it? Injuries again. Here's Miller. Jolly through some traffic. Did it well, the big man. Now it's Jackson and Pendlebury one-on-one. Big Ivan came through and did some nice work. Pendlebury took it away from him, though. Chris Newman lost his legs from underneath him. Foley. Well done, Nate Foley, to Martin. Martin, great foot use. Grigg. Nahas. Ellis under pressure. Got it back to Grigg. Really applying the screws here at the moment, the Magpies. Their pressure at the ball carrier was tremendous. Now, he's making the attempt there. Was it genuine? The umpire said yes.
Just if Richmond want to evolve as a side, they're going to have to get better defensively from the stoppage in the middle. That last goal Daisy Thomas kicked, he burst out of the middle inside the forward 50, and he was there forever. No one picked him up.
Cochin to Deledio. Gee, that was smooth. Vickery needed to get the hands out in front, Duke style. No good trying to mark that on the chest. Nahas to Cochin. Cochin, one thing to do, and that is bend it around the corner. Grigg. Edwards arrives, gives it to Riewoldt. And a throw, said the umpire. Had a good look at it. Jack doesn't like it.
One arm up and then...
BT, you mentioned Ty Vickery going out of the chest mark there.
It's got to be stationary.
The Richmond forwards, Vickery's had three touches for one mark and Riewoldt eight touches for two marks. They're just not getting any real representation from their key forwards. They need them to hold onto the marks and trap it in their forward line.
About that decision, looked okay on the replay to me. Grigg probably would need to see it again, but Jack questioned the umpire. Inside 50s, total 39-31, 12-7 in this quarter. The 12 inside 50s have netted them six goals. So as Richo talks about the efficiency, that is as good as it gets. Penalty Jolly and now Tuvey. Tuvey splits the middle and wasn't a great kick in the end. Grimes at the back and now Rance. Morris.
Well, Lingy's spot on there. He's talking about forwards taking marks. So if you're going to play three tall forwards like Richmond have in the first two rounds of the year, Miller, Vickery and Riewoldt, then you need to take marks inside 50. They'll last for marks inside 50 in round one, and they've only taken the three so far tonight. So that would be of concern for Damien Hardwick.
Greek, the third man up in the contest. Blair ran into a bit of a brick wall. Marty Clark, great story since coming back from Ireland. I know he played previously and was a very, very capable player, but he's come back, fitted straight into this side. Looks like he never left.
Yeah, it's a great effort, isn't it, to disappear. His first season as an Irish player was just remarkable, and great to see him back out here in the black and white stripes.
Yes, Alan Richardson was the man responsible for Marty Clark's very, very quick learning curve.
Hey,
when he arrived at Collingwood, now at Carlton as an assistant coach, of course. Alan Richardson.
They tell me Marty Clark is an aerobic animal.
A beast.
Just can run and run and run. And you underestimate the Irish boys sometime, Richo, but they're very, very tough. They're very determined. And Marty Clark has got all those great attributes.
Great competitors, aren't they?
I think he just lost the passion. I know that sounds silly for such a young player in his first couple of years of footy, but from the reports, he just lost the real, you know, hunger to want to do it. And obviously going home was very much on his mind.
There's the Richmond forward 50 just panning out of it now, but there's three tools in there at the moment. It's just not working. They're going to have to change the mix down there. The ball's going in and out very quickly, and they're not taking marks. So if that's the case, you've got to change it up a little bit.
Who is the best contested mark in the Richmond side, Richo? Who's the one that's...
Jack is the best contested mark in the side, no doubt about that.
He's playing on Keith there. Rig over the top, Swan. Beams back in the side this week. Gives it off to Clark, I think it was, around the corner. Pendlebury flew high, couldn't hold the mark off hands. Lurking dangerously on that occasion was Payne. Deledio went and got it. Foley always sharp with the hands. Here's Grigg. The oncoming ball, he had to be careful. Alice out the back door. Conker had it knocked out in the tackle. So did Alice. That's why it's play on. Correct call from the umpire. Deledio's in there. Beams. And eventually a ball up.
Some of the ferocious defensive forward pressure that has become such a trademark of the really good sides, and Collingwood as good as anyone at that particular part of the game.
Well, they started it, I reckon, didn't they? A couple of years ago, this forward press, and just so good at it.
Swan 10 in this quarter, Greek 10 in the quarter, so both of those players getting plenty of the ball. Gee, Tuck almost handed it out the back door. Tuvey pursued by Foley. Greek through traffic. Gee, being pinged for the throw there. Not disagreeing though, so looks like he might have been guilty as charged. Alan Tuvey to the fat side of the ground. On the head of Dawes, who just can't see the mark contested at the moment. Around the corner, Blair. It'll have a little bit too much bend on it. Alice did well to work it through for a rush behind.
Great trust within the Collingwood team of backing their forwards in one-on-one. And Dawes didn't take the mark, but as soon as the opportunity was there to keep, they will pull the trigger at every occasion. Now, think at the other end, the balance of Richmond. Jack Riewoldt is one of the better one-on-one players in the competition. I haven't seen him in a one-on-one contest yet, but he's been there at times. They've just got to get the balance right. So I can't hold on to the footy, but you've still got to give your forwards a chance one-on-one.
Indeed you do. Here's Seedsman. Sells some foot candy out wide, brings it back in. Did well to get there, Edwards. Handball through traffic, comes to Riewoldt. Riewoldt over to Batchelor, keeps it running forward. This is great play by Batchelor. He's looking around for running support. He just handballed it forward, hoping someone would be on the end of it. Didn't have a lot of other choice. Gold sack and ball, and Marty Clark uses it by foot. Here's side bottom. Into Sinclair. Turns around and goes. Dawes has got the opportune body position, couldn't make it work, lost contact with Marich. Body contact with Marich then. Newman and Cochin to tidy things up. 48-point margin here at the moment. Hooley, Morris, Alice and Rant all combining for the Tigers. Gee, that's just panic use of the footy, isn't it? Rant has got to understand that when he can give it off by hands, he must do it.
Damien Harper, you can see Richo just a big, big deep breath and almost, can't believe it. But the play was set up on the brilliance of Rant and his courage and his ability to get through. As we keep saying up here, we're not being disparaging, but you've got to play within your limitations in the game, and at the moment, you just can't get that right.
Well, some of the best defenders slip Heath Shaw, attack here first.
And he does. Nice ball out wide. And a free kick. Chop of the arm, said the umpires. Richo, what were you going to say there?
Well, some of the best defenders are just nullifying their opponents over the years. They know their limitations. I look at, like, a Collingwood, Simon Prestigiacomo. He did the job week in, week out as a defender. He rarely kicked the ball. When he got the ball, he gave it off to a runner or someone who was a better disposer of the football and just got the job done. And I guess as you learn in your education as a footballer, you've got to know what your strengths and weaknesses are.
Kick two in the quarter, this man, and that won't be the third.
Got a fair bit of strut about him, Alex Mazzola. One of the great celebrators in his first couple of games. I think he might have been tapped on the shoulder and said, Alex,
just reeled in a bit.
Just hold on to that. Which I'm not a favour of. We like to get him out there. But
a 50-metre penalty here. We encourage all celebrators to get out there and do your best stuff. Even if they are going to cop the wrath of the coaching staff, we like it.
And then we may turn on you.
Yeah, at some stage. So, Grimes. See the kick sideways by Grimes there? That's what he's capable of doing. Now, let's see Rance. Runs forward. Couple of bounces. He's got the opportunity to give it to Deledio. He elected not to and kicked it long to the contest when Deledio could have had the free ball. That's exactly what we're talking about, a clear example. There is Dawes, Beams. Handball comes back in the Rewalt direction. Bit of a no-looker there from Jack. Over the line and out of bounds. Sure, you don't get a clearer example than what we saw then.
And Brett Deledio wasn't happy, Brian. There's no doubt he is one of the designated kickers in the side. He was out. You have to give him the handball in that situation.
He's the leading possession gatherer on the ground, Alex Rance, at 25 disposals.
So, replay that when we get an opportunity. Kick forward in the meantime to Goldsack. Not quite taken through by Nahas. Now it is.
He's had a good night. He's won the football, but just got to do...
I'm sure the coaches have told him what we're saying, and he understands that. It just must be the fact that you get caught up in the moment of the game and unable to control your sort of adrenaline emotions.
Hard thing to teach composure and poise, isn't it?
It's a time thing, isn't it?
Yeah, I reckon it is. Or some players, Scotty Penry, the game slows down when he's around the footy. Trent Cochin, likewise, at the other end of the scale. But I think there's so much to like about Rance. You will be able to coach him into just getting that part of his game right.
Harry O'Brien just has to be careful. That's a great example of poise around the corner there from O'Brien. Here's Reed, the link up with Swan. Swan can go all the way. He winds up those little legs. Got it inside 50 and sprayed it.
Really interesting watching Trent Cochin off the ball there as the Tigers play this one. Cochin giving the chase, putting his hand up, screaming at the defenders, going, hey, guys, someone has got to come out and meet Dane Swan. All the Richmond defenders backing away. Swan was going to go coast to coast, but good leadership there from Cochin.
Tuck with a kick off the side of the boot after he absorbed a bit of pressure. Here is Cochin. Cochin looks and says, I'll give it to a man in a better position. Conker lets it rip. It's bending back. It's a goal. Got their second goal of the quarter, the Tigers. Right on the three-quarter time siren. So Conker gets the goal, closes the margin to a 41-point margin in favour of Collingwood. Final quarter action coming up on the other side of the break. It's Collingwood 11, 12, 17, 8. Richmond 4, 13, 37.
In the clearances in that first 10 minutes, and that's when Collingwood did all the damage. Got to get back on front in that area if they want to get anything out of this game, Richmond.
Start of the last quarter. Collingwood by 41 points. Martin, Cochin. And Richmond with a positive start here to Conker. Drawing handball to Jackson. Jackson gets a good look and plenty of time. He goes to the one-on-one in Vickery. Vickery elevates, couldn't quite get it on the second bite. A little unlucky there. Thomas, the man that did the damage in the third quarter. That's a horrible kick from Dale Thomas. Newman.
It's a unique thing the Collingwood defence have got on a turnover to still set their defence up. They don't get hurt when they turn it over.
Jolly and Reed colliding in the air there. Foley trying to funnel it out. He had his nose smashed in early in this game. Nahas was the sub that was activated by Jake King's absence. Here is Harry O'Brien. A little around the ball. I think it was Fasolo. Got it into Dawes. Dawes can go over the top if he wants to. Payne as the kick got the length. Getting back now is Batchelor. Payne couldn't quite get there. Went without the ball. Seedsman then managed to reel it in. Got around one. Got around two. Caught in the tackle. Gone. Bashahuli.
Good effort, Jakey Batchelor. Thank there. You. Way out of position.
Yeah.
Able to go back and create a contest. Good sign.
Yeah.
Umpire apologising then. So White Conker went without the ball. That was not a good look for Conker. Seedsman. Deledio. Richmond in control here at the moment. Cochin involved. Jackson involved. Over the top, they turn it over again. Collingwood will now go forward. Swan with a horrible kick down to Doc Harkins.
Yeah, Jack Rewald has to re-emerge. He's sitting on the bench, Brian. Looks like he'll be right to go soon.
Alice. Out wide, finds Grigg. Halfback here, the Tigers. This is the way they played in the first quarter and a bit, where they were very slow, methodical, and slowed it down.
Well, there's nothing Sean Grigg could do then. Looking up the ground, he had nothing to go to. There wasn't enough spread into the space. There was space on the wing, but just no spread or gut running to present for him.
Nice kick by Rance, finds Ellis. Brandon Ellis, once he finds his feet, very professionally prepared young man, this guy. Bashahuli meeting Cat Stevens before the game here today. He loved that. Not liking what he's seeing out there at the moment. Have a look at this over the top. Comes to Miller. Miller kicked the first goal of the game for the Tigers. Comes in, kicks the first goal of the last quarter.
It's a nice gift over the back for Brad Miller. Hasn't really got involved in this game, apart from, as BT just said, first goal and now a late goal, only five possessions. And really need a little bit more out of that man there.
Well, there was an open forward line here and Brad Miller found himself out the back. You won't see an easier goal than that one. There haven't been a lot of easy goals for Richmond tonight.
Marriage. Deledio with the clearance. So Richmond starting positively here in this final quarter. Deledio, they're only 35 down here, the Tigers. I say only. That's tough for the Tigers, but not insurmountable.
Let's get down to Dr. Peter Larkins. Jack Rewald's back out there, Doc.
Yeah, he's back on the ground, Das. Look, you know he had a lot of off-season surgery, so he had hips and hands and ankles and hips to talk about, but he was down for a while. Looks like he's running around smoothly now.
Vickery. Jackson caught in the Heath Shaw tackle. Ball was pinned to him as he made an attempt. Umpire said yes.
Got to give him reason and time. Opportunity. Thanks, mate.
So within 25 metres of the Richmond goal here, great opportunity for them. Jolly. Well on the ruck. Bashahuli went up without a lot of thought. Over the top, Richmond through Grimes, gives it off to Ellis. Ellis takes the kick he can make, good decision by him.
Play on!
Umpire says to Rancher, ran off the line, and that is just horrible. He had the easy kick sideways to Ellis. And he wanted to work the angle instead with a much more difficult kick.
And he tries his hardest, but then what happens when it gets turned over is his opponent, Travis Cloak, ends up getting the ball. which hurts even more.
We've been talking about Alex Rance a lot tonight. The question to get involved in, join the conversation. We're live on Saturday Night Footy. Have the Saturday Night team been a little too harsh on that man, Alex Rance, or have we been fair?
Well, we may well have been, Das. I think his kicking percentages actually look quite good, with the exception of that third quarter. Here's Cochin. Opportunity to skip out. Full of class, this guy. Rewalt presented. Did he have the arms knocked? Reed. Clark's there. Well done, Rewalt. Knock on to Jackson. Got back inside. Lovely control from Jack Rewalt to find Miller. And Richmond, a chance to kick consecutive goals in a quarter for the first time.
And this is why they do like getting Jack Rewalt up the ground, because he is a good finisher by foot and he makes good decisions. And that time on his left foot was a beautiful kick to Brad Miller.
I'm still giving the Tigers some chance from here, Darce. This will get it back to 29.
Like your positive energy, Brian.
I am telling you right now, the Tigers have just been doing the attacking here in the last. Miller must kick the goal. It looks good. It's straight. The Tigers are back within 29 and their supporters find voice.
Just a little bit of excitement here at the MCG. They've been quiet for all the third quarter, the yellow and black fans. And the Bristol has just given them some hope. As we look at the clock, only 6.5 minutes into the final term, and a couple in a row to Brad Miller.
Well, the Collingwood fans just looking a little nervous. One man there packing his bag and saying, it's in the bag, I'm going home. Joffa looking nervous. They've kicked three of the last four goals in this game, the Tigers. Pendlebury out of the middle with a kick wide. So Richmond again. Knock on from Greg is good. Lockie Keefe with his hands over the ball. The smother. I'm telling you, they're starting to mount a challenge here. Here's Rewalt. They go in and under. Low there. O'Brien.
Well, if you take out that 10-minute period at the start of the third quarter where they kicked five goals, Collingwood, that was the difference. They blew it open in that period of time. But that's what good sides do. They go bang in a short period of time and take the game away from you.
This is a good 7.5-minute patch here from the Tigers. Need to keep it going. Lovely tap from Jolly to Pendlebury. Newman over the top, couldn't pick it off. Fasolo, not clear on the tackle. Here's Rance, trying his guts out here. Handball inside, that's better. Foley on the attack again. You've got to like the build-up here at the moment. Edward says, come on, come at me. Rewalt drops in behind Reed. He'll have to jump over the top. He couldn't. Stay down. Reed did well. Under pressure to side bottom. Side bottom along the ground to Swan. Swan needs to be clean. Batchelor did well to worry him out of it. Conceded back inside. Now Collingwood with the numbers. A little too easy on that occasion was Fasolo, very relaxed in his attitude to win the ball in the hands. Clark, what a wonderful kick that is to Swan.
Wow.
Umpire says go, drawing handball to Sinclair. Big Ivan's got to run him down. He does.
That is super from the ruckman.
Well done, Ivan Maric.
Had the big strides going. Ivan is pumping the arms.
He had two big strides left in him.
He was gone after that.
After that, there was no reserve stride. And I tell you what, it saved the Tigers, because now they get a chance to reload and go again. Only have to trim this margin off bit by bit. Don't have to get it all in one smack. Good mark taken there by Payne.
Stay clear.
Jackson Payne. Gee, Ivan Maric was within the 5-metre perimeter there and very, very lucky not to be penalised 50 metres.
Push out. Way too early. Too early.
Croker's rather agitated by that decision. Too early, said the umpire with the push out. Martin, a little inside out kick. Here's a man that can use it. They've got the loose out wide here, the Tigers. It's Newman. Another good user by foot. Nahas presents at him. He ignores that.
Hasn't got much ahead. Ben Reid sitting on his own with Darren Jolly inside 50.
Delidio gets it back to Martin. Martin just steps off his man and says, OK, can't go forward. Just hang on to the ball sideways for a moment. So getting it into the hands of the guys that can use it. Newman. Nice little present up from Bashahuli. Patient forward thrust again from the Tigers.
Yeah, they have to be patient because they've got a loose in Ben Reed sitting right in the hot spot. They've got to get over and mount him up.
Bashahuli goes for the long ball. Here comes Rewalt. Did he he did infringe with the hands in the back.
Just in that situation, though, when you've got loose players back, you still need a forward to present with a real dynamic lead at the ball because you might actually attract the attention of the loose man and drag him over. If you all stand still, they're not going to move at all.
And Rewalt just overcooked it as he tried to take mark of the year. That had to just come to ground.
So here's Pope. He'll get the free this time. So we've played some 11 minutes here in this final quarter.
Play on.
Richmond trimming away at the lead, but the clock's starting to work against them if they don't get one fairly quickly here now. Bashahuli in hard and low. Bursting out or attempting to was Payne.
Thank you.
Here's the big play before Ivan. As you said, Brian, there was another stride left.
There was nothing.
Or he was gone.
How he didn't snap one of his muscles off the bone then, Big Ivan.
Ruckman aren't meant to chase like that. That was fantastic.
It was Jackson. Tuck. Rewalt gets rid of his man. It's legal. The umpire says it's OK. Gee, Jack, just a bit of a one-trick pony there at the moment. Clark, funny little Irish kick through, wasn't it? Harry O'Brien back to Clark. Caught in the tackle. That's incorrect disposal, umpire. Picked up in the end by Deledio, 50 metres out. Third consecutive goal for the Tigers. I'm telling you, Das, they're coming.
They are
coming, Richmond. Brett Deledio with his second goal in the game. Richmond have kicked the last three and they're now within 23 points.
Well, massive play for the Tigers. And just ask a question here in this game tonight. Are they capable?
Get behind your mob, Richmond fans, because I am telling you they've kicked four of the last five goals. They've kicked three in a row in this last quarter and they've closed to within 23 points. Alice in the middle. Pendlebury needs to get involved now and he does. Kick is wide, side bottom, through traffic, handball over the top to the big man Jolly, gets a free look at the punt right goal, Collingwood through Jolly.
Yeah, well that breaks your heart if you're a Richmond fan. That was Scotty Pendlebury, the champ who got involved. Got their clearance, but a ruck goal from a centre bounce really hurts.
Well, we see that there. This is great play by Jaron Jolly. Did his work in the ruck and then bolted forward. Unfortunately, Tyrone Vickery didn't react quick enough, and there's Darren Jolly running inside 50. Smart play.
Out of the middle they come again here. Tuck trying to force the ball. Didn't have a lot of helpers on that occasion. Ball around the corner. Disappointing crowd here at the MCG tonight. Just 57,268.
I think you might even be being a little kind to Tyrone, Richo. He was backing away from the contest, trying to earn a footy in a position where he didn't ever need to be. He had to go and defend there. That's the basic skill of the game as a ruck. You can't get out the back and look for a cheap one in that situation. Not good enough.
Just rolled the dice, Dars. You can't do it at a 50-50.
Very costly.
Cotchin and Newman involved. And all out in the Grimes direction. Dylan Grimes.
Play on! You.
Now Grigg. Grigg says, come on, present up at the ball. I can hit that target. Nahas does. Now they find the loose over the top. Morris takes them on with some inside running. What's he got? gives it to Tuck. Tuck did well back to Nahas. Nahas gets a look at the Miller lead. He ignores that. Bounce inside. Too heavy for Riewoldt. Needed to be lower and shorter. Disappointing delivery. Swan Miller. Clever tap on. Jackson from the boundary line with a left foot bender. Oh, boy. Don't know whether that kick was on.
He's clear. Come on. Let's switch on.
I think if he had his time again, Jack Harvey would have preferred to have centred that ball. Brett Deledio was making his way into the corridor.
Vickery coming down to compete, but the numbers overwhelming in the Pies' favour from that stoppage. Quote going at it with Rance. Rance did well.
Once again, it's just where they're at as a side, Richmond, at the moment, in their development. As we look at Dan Jackson's left foot banana, not sure that's within Jacko's capabilities.
No. Don't try that too often. Quote went to ground. Was he infringed? Oh, Rance got a high bump from Thomas on the shoulder. And a free kick will go Rance's way, and Cloak is disappointed.
He always puts his head over the ball, Alex Rance, and he's won the ball beautifully tonight. And once he just polishes up his disposal and decision-making, he's going to be a very good defender at this level.
Grimes. Love the way he plays. Always looking to give it off to a player that's perhaps a better user. Bashahuli, Martin. Half back, got caught, lost control of the ball. Dustin Martin, big turnover this one. Cloak says, will I pass it or go for home? In the end, he confused himself.
Had too much time to think about it in the end, Cloaky.
I like the inbounds ball for Richmond. It's quick, it's effective to Nahas, and now Ellis. Already on the wing, in a flash. Nahas, power of running here in the last quarter. No one can get hold of him. The kick to Riewoldt. Riewoldt could have almost got there, decided to let it bounce.
He's a super player, Ben Reid. He works the angles just sensationally well. When he needs to come up and defend, then you saw him right on that Riewoldt's hammer. If he gets in a position where he doesn't think he needs to be, Richo, the best player is sifting off and helping out.
Look at the eyes on that man there. Ivan. Guys with eyes like that, you tend to stay away from. Opportunity out of the middle to Thomas. Bit of a party trick over the top to Sinclair. Basher got him in the tackle nicely. So a 30-point margin with 7 minutes remaining. There they are. Gee, they're really finding the lights. Ivan. Pies next week setting up a mouth-watering clash with Carlton on Friday night. And, of course, the Tigers will play Melbourne also here at the MCG. Martin. Out of the middle. Riewoldt's got two to beat. Reed did well again. Tuck. Back to Nahas. Nahas needed to thread the needle. Touched by Blair anyway. Now Griggs got it. Funny little kick around the corner, but effective to Conker. Needs to go back and kick the goal. It was Reece Conker.
Reece! Stay there!
Pye putting him back on the angle.
Where
a little.
Where standing?
Conker acknowledges. And now needs to get it done.
Leds!
Just
come
a
out, mate.
Very outside chance at the moment for the Tigers. Fourth goal on offer in the quarter. For the Tigers, their best quarter of football. They did play well in the first as well. Conker a little bit left. What do you make of the footy we're seeing tonight, Darce, in terms of last week, the attacking footy, lots of goals. Tonight we're seeing a rather defensive game.
Not what I expected, to be honest with you, BT. I'm used to Collingwood just being able to pile on goals. As we mentioned, they did it for that 10-minute period in the third quarter, played on and scored 5 in 6 minutes, but look, I'm going to pay a fair bit of credit to Richmond tonight. A lot at stake for them. I think it's been a pretty disciplined performance. Throw there against Jack Riewoldt. They've come out with some intent, Richo. They haven't played necessarily an attractive brand of football, but if you're Richmond supporters, all right, at least on a big stage, we've taken it up to one of the very good sides, Richo.
In the first half, I think they played the way that they probably wanted to play. They actually had more of the ball when it was an even contest, except for a few decision-making things here and there, but it was just that third quarter, 6 minutes of footy.
Holding the footy.
Goltzak caught with the footy. Free kick to Deledio. The way he's looked at that ball, I think he might be thinking barrel here.
Well, is that a pretty good guy?
He is. He's saying, I'm going in and I'm going for the barrel, perhaps. Is it or not? Kick on the way, drop punt it is. Might get the journey.
It's a leading possession getter on the ground, Brett Deledio. Kicked a couple of goals. He's had a pretty good night. Couldn't have done much more than that.
Thank you. Hold there, Chris.
Pendlebury to Shaw, Shaw to O'Brien. O'Brien will go to side bottom. And they've got the loose downfield as well. Can come in the gold sack.
Keep watching!
Take that. Wants to go further inboard to Blair. Blair drops an easy mark. Hulley was able to tidy it up. Conker wanted it. Somehow managed to conjure up a kick while lying on the ground. The top, Batchelor. Good two-grab mark. Ellis. His left side around the corner, Goldsack.
What do you make of Collingwood tonight, Richo, and their performance? Doesn't feel to me as though they've absolutely hit their straps. Still got a lot of players to come back in.
Yeah, I think that's right. They showed what they can do when their quality players got involved at the start of that third quarter. Daisy Thomas, Scott Pendlebury, Travis Cloak. They turned it on when they had to, but they're probably about 75% of capacity, and they've still got a lot of players to come back in.
We're all looking for a change of style in the Magpies as we see Hooley try and work that one through. Are you detecting anything noticeably different in the first two rounds?
There is no doubt that they're prepared to come inboard. They were instructed to really not come inboard at all in the last few years. They'd go down the line, but there's no doubt they're taking a lot more risks in that back half and prepared to come through the corridor under Nathan Buckley. He does, I think, prefer a bit of corridor footy. No doubt about that.
Pensive Nathan Buckley there. They lead it by 28 points. Inside 50 entry. Saw Luke Ball there before. Playing his 50th game for the Collingwood Footy Club now, Luke Ball.
I think under Nick Mouldhouse, I mean, you could come inboard, but it had to be really, really on. But they seem to be just taking a few more risks now.
Opportunity here. The ball into the middle into disputed territory. The race is on. Here's Deledio, his 95th consecutive game for the Tigers. O'Brien wins out. Reed. Wide ball. Tuvi just looking like struggling for the run at the moment. Why wouldn't you towards the end of this game? Edwards. Side bottom kept it alive very cleverly. Dawes with the big frame did likewise. And in the end, the boundary umpire.
Throw it in.
Richo, we spoke a lot about Dustin Martin in the pre-game. How have you seen his game tonight against the quality midfield of Collingwood?
He's been okay. I wouldn't say he's had his best start to the season. He's had the 20 disposals. Hasn't been able to get on the scoreboard, which is a strength of his. I'd like to see him push forward a little bit more. He is very good one-on-one. Still only 20 years of age. Still got a lot to learn, but he has done some nice things.
Play on!
I think he's standing there on Scott Pendlebury now.
Play on.
It's not a bad way to learn how to get the right running patterns.
Richmond, Rance tries to just bore a hole through the Collingwood players. Newman, fast hands, impressive to Morris. Funny little kick by Morris. It sort of got there on the bounce to Greg, and now Morris fires up. That's better. Hits Jackson on the lead. Jackson to Miller. Knocked away from him. And Shaw's hurt his hip on that one.
Maxie Heath.
And Miller will line up for his fourth goal for the Tigers. Plays on. Gives it to Deledio. Deledio to the top of the square, dangerously for the Pies. Knocked through for a behind. Didn't look too good, Heath Shaw, out of that.
Don't mind what Brad Miller did then. He gave it off to Brett Deledio, who is a good kick of the football. And it was a nice set-up kick to the top of the square.
He might have given the groin a bit of a rip then, Heath Shaw. Taken by Payne. Out of sight of the MCG for Solo. Jackson. Nahas, who was the activated sub and with the injury to Jake King. Vickery to Martin. Regan, now Jackson.
Thought he had a great year last year, Ty Vickery.
Stay clear.
36 goals and really playing the forward ruck role really well. Had a bit of a slow start to his 2012. Just the 7 disposals again tonight. Was quiet last week. So some real scope for him to get his season improving.
Good mark taken. Rance. Great use. Miller. We'll get another look at the goal with just under a minute remaining.
That was great run from Alex Rance. He hasn't stopped trying all night. I know we've talked about a couple of decision-making things that he's made tonight and a few skill errors, but his effort has been 110%, as always. He's got a pretty good base to work with.
15 inside 50s in this quarter for the Tigers, and they've kicked 3 goals out of that. Had a couple of other opportunities they've missed. And this is one more of them, Miller. As we close in on the final siren, kick on the way. Looks pretty good. And they make it a 4-goal quarter, and the Richmond fans enjoy that. Brad Miller with 3 last quarter goals here to get the Tigers within 21 points.
It's been a funny game, this one. It was just the first half, it was a lot of possession, not much scoring, some real sloppy skill errors. And then straight after half-time, Collingwood go bang with some real class. And then from that moment forward, it was an even game again. So it was won and lost in 6 minutes, this game.
It's the Richmond fans up on their feet there. You can see something to get excited about. They had a great summer, really performed well in the NAB Cup Series, and come up against 2 very good teams first up. And I like the way they've gone about it tonight, Richard. There's stuff that they can take away from tonight that is very positive.
There'll be no more scoring in this game. And it's going to be the first win of the year for the Magpies. Fasolo, I think, will get the opportunity to shoot a goal here. He'll go the spiral.
Play on.
And the umpire lets him go. That's a magnificent kick from Fasolo.
No score. I think he played on.
He called play on. He went off the mark. So a big win here for the Magpies tonight. 21-point victors over the Tigers. For a 21-point victory here over the Tigers. 12-13-85 to Richmond, 8-16-54.
Yeah, first win to Nathan Buckley as a senior coach, as Travis Cloak and Ivan Marich exchanged pleasantries at the end of the game. Haven't really hit their full capacity going, but they just gave a little signal, Richo, that 5-minute burst of what they're capable of. They'll start filtering some of their more experienced players back through and just continue to improve the Pies as this year rolls on.
So a big win here for the Pies to kick off their season. Of course, next weekend they set up a Friday night clash with Carlton. Big game that. And the Tigers will play Melbourne, who got absolutely shellacked today. Let's go down to Cameron Ling on the ground.
Pendles, a bit of a battle there at the start of the game. Richmond took it up to you a bit, but in the end you got over the top. Nice to get the win.
Yeah, it is. Good to get the first 4 points of the year. We knew they're a side that, you know, they played really well last week for that first half. And we knew they were going to try and, you know, stick with it for a bit longer. And they did that. They're a very good side. And credit to our boys for grinding it out.
And a really great burst of play there in the third quarter by the boys. 5 or 6 goals in quick succession. That's no doubt the type of footy you want to play going forward.
Yeah, I think we're just really predictable moving the ball into our forward line. You know, I think we're the best side at kicking long points, so we want to fix that and start getting shots nice and close and make them really easy.
6-day break now. Carlton on Friday night. They had a fantastic win against Brisbane last Thursday night. Be a great battle.
Yeah, it will be. It's always good to play the Blues and no doubt big crowd. And they're up and about and we've got a bit of work to do, so no doubt we'll dissect their game and see how we go.
Well done tonight, mate. Thanks for your time.
Thanks, Lee. Cheers, man.
He's got Pendlebury down there, pretty happy to get away with a 21-point victory here. Rather disappointing crowd, by the way, 57,268. And just a workmanlike performance today from the Pies,
Yeah, it was. And if you have a look at Collingwood's team tonight, they had eight players in their squad before this game started that had played under 20 games. So a lot of younger players out there still learning their way in the Cape. And Nathan Buckley tinkered with the game plan a little bit. They're probably still getting used to that. So still got a lot of improvement left in this season, Collingwood, obviously. And for Richmond, just some vital mistakes at crucial times, decision-making cost them.
OK, let's get back down to Linger. He's got Dale Thomas.
Dale, forget about the footy, mate. Have you been getting a wave over the last week? It's been absolutely pumping. How's the preparation for the game?
It was good, mate. Jared Blair and I snuck off on Thursday, so managed to get wet. Been watching a bit of it on the telly too, but obviously a good preparation for tonight. The boys got the job done.
Certainly must have helped you in that third quarter. Had an absolutely blistering quarter. Kicked three goals, broke the game open. You must have been wrapped with that.
Yeah, obviously I need to do something, mate. I've been pretty quiet till then, so, you know, it's nice to contribute in a small way. And I feel the other boys rallied too, so to get the job done, you know, it was a bit disappointing in that last quarter there. We let them get a few easy ones, but, you know, we're in the winner's circle.
Get in there and enjoy it with the boys, mate. Well done.
Cameron Ling down there with the Pies boys that are pretty inwardly happy about the win here today.
And they're inwardly happy that Cameron Ling is interviewing them rather than running around alongside them as well. But, yeah, they'll come away, and a game that they expected to win. They got the job done. Without you know, a heap of fanfare, a heap of fuss, but it was a bizarre night tonight.
It was
not the way you expected this game to unfold. The end result probably is about where I expected it in the end.
There you can see a disappointed Richmond Rooms. Not happy with their start to the season, of course. Consecutive losses now to both Carlton and Collingwood. It was always going to be a tough opening for them.
They always knew they had a tough start, and they're right in the game last week up until the 10-minute mark of the last quarter, and tonight it was, you know, lapses of concentration at key periods that cost them. They just need to hang tough, and obviously next week's a big game. They play Melbourne. They need to get the job done there.
Luke Ball playing his 50th game with the club there. Harry O'Brien and Travis Cloak enjoying the moment. Trav was quite grumpy tonight at various stages. It's a big win for the Magpies here. They got the job done tonight at the MCG, winning 12-13-85 to Richmond 8-16-64. So plenty more to come, of course, on the other side of the break. We'll be taking you right through tonight, have all the latest, not just on this game here, but every other game that has taken place. A couple of stories starting to develop in football from other games today. So stay with us on the other side of the break. All the latest coming your way. Tonight, it was Collingwood over Richmond by 21 points.
There's no stopping us right now. And there's no stopping us right now.